Welcome to the tutorial, Dynamed, a quick introduction. Dynamed is a point-of-care tool that has been designed to give you answers to clinical questions in 30 seconds or less. To get to it, go to the library's website, medlib.bu.edu. Hover over e-resources, click on e-books. It's listed underneath quick links alphabetically as Dynamed. You'll be prompted to log into it with your BU username and password, also known as your Kerberos. You must have this active in order to be able to access Dynamed. In order to use Dynamed, use this Google-like search box. Let's say that you have a question about your patient's kidney stones. Go ahead and type kidney stones into the search box, and then hit enter. Dynamed will pull up what it thinks is possibly relevant on the left-hand side. When you hover over them, it pulls out a summary of what this item contains. This helps you figure out if it's what you're looking for without you having to actually click on it. Now you can see a kidney stone is what you want, so go ahead and click on it. Right at the top of the entry, Dynamed tells you that this entry was last updated with evidence provided on March 22, 2013. Now, I'm recording this video on April 20th, 2013, so you can see that it's been about a month since there was an update for this item. Any good point-of-care tool will be very open with you about when they last updated their information. This is important for you to know how recent your evidence is that you are using in your patient care decisions. On the left-hand side, you can see all the different options you have. There is complications, history and physical, diagnosis, etc. What you generally will probably be coming to Dynamed for is the treatment option, so go ahead and click on that. And you can see that it provides a treatment overview. And for each entry, such as this one talking about NSAIDs, it'll tell you what level of evidence we're working with here. So if you click on it, these are the different levels of evidence that Dynamed works with. Level 1 is likely reliable, level 2 is mid-level, and level 3 is lacking direct evidence. Every point-of-care tool that is good should not only tell you what evidence they use, but what level of evidence it is. Some of them grade them with numbers like this, and others grade them with letters, just like you get graded in school. So an A is the best, and a D would be bad. So it's good when you're looking at this clinical information to know what level of evidence you're talking about. Is it level 1, level 2, or level 3? So sometimes you'll have a treatment option and it will be very clear that this option is exactly what you need, and other times it's less clear because there's not exactly evidence yet pointing out that that is the best treatment option. There are other good resources within Dynamed. It provides the ICD-9 and ICD-10 codes that you'll need when you're writing up the information. It has guidelines and resources right here. And it also provides the references to the evidence that they used to make these decisions, which is also important. Any good point-of-care tool will be very clear and thorough about what they used to come to these conclusions so that you can follow it up for yourself. It also contains patient information, such as PDF handouts that you could click on and print and hand to your patient right in the office to help them understand what it is you're talking about with them. Now let's say that you have decided you're really interested in kidney stones and you want to be updated on this as new information comes in. If you click on this little red alarm bell and enter your email and tell it how often you want to get updates, an alert will come in for you whenever there are updates or in the increments that you told it you want updates. Now, you can also just check in on recent updates in general, not just search by just one topic. If you click on recent updates, you can see here everything is entered in as the most recently updated. You can see, as I said, today is April 20th, and there was something changed in Dynamed as recently as 12:24 p.m. You can also view it by category. So say you were on rotation in emergency medicine. You could click on that and then see only the information that is important for emergency medicine. You can even further limit it to just the practice-changing updates. And that means that if you wouldn't get minor updates. You would only get things that are really important. Like if a cure for cancer was found or something like that. You would only get the very important life-changing type updates. Now, just like in the individual entries, for this entry for general emergency medicine practice-changing updates, you can use this little red alarm bell to get the alerts sent to you. So say you were on rotation in emergency medicine, you could get these emails about the most recent evidence in emergency medicine sent to you. Dynamed also has calculators for you to use for medical equations, clinical criteria, decision trees, statistics, units and dose converters, and you can search these calculators by specialty. Calculators are something you will use a lot, so it's good to know that they exist here in Dynamed. Now, there's also a mobile app that you can use for Dynamed. If you click on mobile, it explains the app further. Essentially, you need to download a free app called Skyscape and then email Dynamed's support using this email right here from your BU email address and explain to them that you're a student so that they understand that you have access and ask them for the access code. You can then within Skyscape download Dynamed using the access code that they will give you. They usually respond within 24 hours. And the app works very similarly to the website itself. And that is a quick introduction to Dynamed. Thank you for watching A Quick Introduction to Dynamed. For more information about this or any other library resources or services, please feel free to contact the Reference Desk at 617-638-4228 or RefQuest at bu.edu.